welcome to SPS in online classes, and I am your math teacher. And students, now we are going to solve math assignment number 10 of grade 8. Fine, okay, beta. As we know that we are already doing chapter number 2, and in chapter number 2 we are already done exercise 2.1, 2.2, 2.3. Now onward we will start exercise 2.4, but before starting new exercise, first we will revise previous point as we already discussed in the previous exercise. So the first point, as we already done about the real number, that from which type of the numbers are called the real number. So as we know that the real number, real numbers, we already learned. So the real number is the combination of rational number and irrational number. We also learned. So then, rational number, which type of the numbers are called the rational number, beta? So a number that can be terminated is called the rational number. Let's suppose 3 by 4. When we will solve 3 by 4, so what will be the answer? You can check that. That 3 and 4. Put the point, write down 0. 4 sevens are 28. Then 2, write down 0 more. Then it will become 20. 4 fives are 20. So it's mean. When we will solve 3.4, you will get 0.075. So it's mean we can terminate our answer. Our 3 by 4, you can simply say that 3 by 4 gave us a exact answer. So that's why we will say that 3 by 4 is a rational number. Rational number means P by Q form, in the P by Q form. So 3 by 4 in the P by Q form, you can say that the fraction number, fraction and the rational number have the same meaning. So rational number is a, they can be terminated. And irrational numbers cannot be terminated. Let's suppose when we will calculate under root 2 or under root 3 on the calculator, so we will get our answer 1.4, 1.42 and so on. So it means under root 2 cannot be terminated, and as the value of E, Y, we cannot terminate the value of these symbols are under root 3, under root 5, so on. So these type of the numbers are called the irrational number. Fine? Okay. And we also learn about the property of real number, different type of the property of the real number. We are, and fourth point is radical and radicand. So radical and radicand. So as we already learned that, let's suppose a number is in the nth root of A. In nth root of A, which one is a radical and which one is a counter radicand? So A is called a radicand, and nth root is called the radicand. Understood, beta? The base is called the radical and the nth root is called the radicand. Okay. Now, after the prior knowledge, come on the new topic. And today we will start exercise 2.4. And 2.4 has some important point. So in this exercise, we will learn about the base and exponent. So I will tell you about the base and exponent, that which type of the symbols are called base and exponent. So let a number is a power n. So in this form, so a is called base and n is called a power or exponent. Power or exponent. Fine. Similarly, let's suppose a number is 5 power 4. So 5 is called a base and 4 is called a exponent or power. Understood, beta? Okay. Now open your book and turn out page number 46. Okay, page 46 and the example number 1, part 2. Okay, first we will do examples and then we will come on the questions of exercise 2.4. Okay, page 46 and example number 1. Okay, example number 1, the first part is x minus 2, x minus 3, y 7 divided by x minus 3 and y 4. Fine. So they are saying they are find out the exact answer or simplify this question. So how we can simplify it? Okay, beta, as we know that when b's are same, powers will add. X and x, so the base are same. We can write x just and then minus 2 plus minus 3. When base are same, the powers will add. So the minus 2 is the power of first variable, first x value, and then the minus 3 is the power of the second x. And then add, they are adding. And now write down y power 7 divided by x minus 3 y power 4. So x minus 2, open the bracket, plus minus minus 3 y 7. Then x minus 3 y 4. X minus minus plus 3 plus 2 5, but sign will minus, because the greater value have negative sign. So y 7 divided by x minus 3 y 4. Now x minus 5, again base are same in the denominator and numerator, so it will jump on the numerator. R, so the power, you can write first x, when x will go on the in the numerator place, the power will opposite. Here the power is minus 3, so when x come on the numerator place, so power will positive, so it will become positive x plus 3. Then y 7 divided by y 4, again base are same, so minus 5 plus 3 y 7 divided by y 4, x plus minus minus 2 y 7 divided by y 4. So again x 2 y will come on the numerator place, so the it will become y, and here the plus 4, so when it will come in the numerator place, the power will opposite minus 1. X minus 2, then y 7 minus 4 3, so it can be write y 3. X minus 2 means it will become or it will come on the denominator x plus 2. This is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. I come on the second part. And the second part is 4a cube b power 0, then 9a minus 5 and minus 2, power minus 2. So first we will convert power minus 2 into the positive 2. How we can convert? So when power will change, our power will, the sign of the power have to change, the value will opposite. So it will come here 4a cube b power 0 divided by 9a power minus 5. So it will become 9a power 5. Then it will come in the denominator 4a 3b power 0 and then write down just 2. Understood, beta? Here the power is minus 2. When it will become plus 2, the value will opposite in the brackets. Okay. Now 9 e power minus 5 divided by 4 a power 3 b power 0. Any variable have a power 0, it will give one answer. B power 0, its mean is equal to 1. X power 0 is equal to 1. Understood, beta? Okay, now B power 0 is equal to 1. So write on dot 1 means multiply 1. So 9 A power minus 5. Again here base are same, so it will come on the numerator. So A, first write on step by step. So it will become minus 3. 9 divided by 4. Base are same, so power will add minus 3 plus minus minus 3. And then 9a power minus 8 divided by 4. 9, 4 and minus 8, its mean it will come on the denominator, it will become a power 8, 2. So now apply the power numerator and denominator both. So 9 square and 4a power 8 whole square. 9 square, 9 nines are 81. And then 4 4s are 16, a 8 power 8 and then power 2, 8 multiply 2, 16. This is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay, now the second example. Come on the second example. And the second example, they are saying simplify the following by using law of indicators. Okay, now the first part is 8 divided by 125 power minus 4 by 3. Simplify. So how we can simplify this question? So first we will change negative power in the positive. So when we will change negative into the positive, the value will turn in the bracket. So it will become 125 divided by 8 and then power will positive. And now 125 as we know that 125, the factor of 125 are 5 2s are 10, 5 5s are 25, 5 5s are 25, and 5 5s are 5. So we can write 5 multiply 5 multiply 5 3 times 5, and then 8 can be write 2 multiply 2 multiply 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, power 4 by 3. Yes. So 5, and it can be write in the index notation, as we already learned in the previous exercise that how we can write the product factor into the exponent notations or index notation. So 5 power 3 multiply, so do the step by step, 2 power 3 and then power 4 by 3. Now apply the power on each number inside the bracket, so it will become 5 power 3 multiply 4 by 3 divided by 2 power 3 multiply 4 by 3. So 3 can be cancelled with the 3, 3 will cancel with 3. So 5 power 4 divided by 2 power 4. So 5 power 4 means 5 will write 4 times. 5 will multiply 4 times. And we will open the bracket. So 2 power 4 means 2 will multiply 4 times. So what will be the answer? 5 5s are 25, 25 5s are 125, 125 5s are 125 multiply 5. 5 5s are 25, 5 2s are 10 and 2, 12, 5 1s are 5 and 1, 6. 6 25 divided by 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. 16. It means 625 divided by 16 is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, the second part of the second example. Okay, now second part, 4, 3 bracket power n divided by 3 power n plus 1 minus 3 power n. So how we can solve this question? Fine. Okay, beta, first 4, 3 power n. Open the bracket, it can be write 3 power n just 3 power n plus 1 minus 3 power n. So 4 into 3 power n divided by, can we take common 3n here? Yes, 3n, and then 3n, so just 3 left inside the bracket. 3 will left inside the bracket and we will take 3n. So as we know that 3n plus 1 is equal to, can be write 3n into 3, just 3. And we know that the power of 3 is 1, so base are same and when power will add. When base are same, the power will add, so it will become 3n plus 1, same. So it can be write 3n into 3. So first write on, if you are feeling the confusion, anything, so you can write 3n first and then 3 minus 3n. 4, 3 power n into, and then take the common 3n from here. So 3 minus just 1. 4 into 3n divided by 3n, 3 minus 1, 2, 3n can be cancelled with 3. So 4 divided by 2 and 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, just 2 is your answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, after the examples and explanation from all the exercise. Come on the exercise. Okay, open your book, sorry, and page number 46. And now we will start exercise 2.4. Fine? Okay, 2.4. Exercise 2.4. And page number 46. And we will start from the question number 1. And in question number 1, they are saying that use law of exponent to simplify. That how we can simplify this question. Beta, I will do just only one part. And then rest all the parts you will do in your notebook. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, the first, second, these are the easy part. Now come on the fourth one. Fourth part. That how we can solve the fourth part. How we can find the exponent. How we can use the law of exponent for simplify this question. Fine. Okay, question number 1. And the part number 4. And part number 4 is 81. Power n and 3 power 5 minus 3 power 4 n minus 1 into 243 divided by 9 power 2 n into 3 power just 3. Okay, now how we can simplify this question? 81. So 81, first find out the factor of 81. 83 twos are 6, 3 sevens are 21, 3 nines are 27, 3 threes are 9, 3 ones are 3, 4 times 3. So 81 can be read. And 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3, 4 times 3, and product form can be write into the exponent notation, means index notation. So 3 power 4, 81 can be write in 3 power 4, yes. 3 power 4 into n, power n. Then 3 power 5 minus 3 power 4 n minus 1. And then find out the factor of 243. 243. So it can be solved by the 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 7s are 21, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9, and 3 1s are 3. So 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times 3. So it means it can be write 3 power 5. Yes. Into 3 power 5. And then 9 can be write 3 power 2. Then 2n power into 3 power 3. So 3. 4 multiply with n, it will become 4n into 3 power 5 minus 3 power 4n minus 1 into 3 power 5. And then 2 multiply 2n, 2 2s are 4, it will become 4n into 3 power 3. Dot means multiply, they are multiply, 3 power 3. Okay. No, we can take the common 3 power 4n and 3 power 5 here. Yes. So 3 power 4n into 3 power 5. Take the common and then just 1 is left here. And then minus 3 power 4 3 power 4 n minus 1 is equal to, can be write in 3 power 4 n into 3 power minus 1. Yes. So when we will take the common from here, 3, 4 and just 3 minus 1 will left. And then 3 power 4 n into 3 power 3. Understood, beta? Okay. No. 3 power 4 n into 3 power 5 and 1 minus 3 power minus 1. Convert this power into the positive 1. So what will be the value? 1 by 3 divide 3 power 4 n into 3 power 3. 3 power 4 n can be cancelled with 3 power 4 n. Yes. And then 3 power 5, it will jump on the numerator. So it will become minus 3. When base are same, 3 and 3 base are same, so power will add. So it will become minus 3, 5 minus 3, 1. And write on 1 in, convert the whole number into the fraction form. So 3, 5 minus 3, 2. Take out the LCM. 3, 3 ones are 3. 1 divided by 3, 3. 3 ones are 3, 3. Minus 3 divided by 3, 1. 1 multiply 1, 1. So 3 power 2, 3, 1. Just 2 divided by 3. 3 power 2 can be write 3 into 3. And just 3, 3 can be cancelled with 3. 3 2s are 6. 3 2s are 6 and 6 is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Okay, now come on the second question of exercise 2.4, and the second question is, they are saying, they show that the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. I have. So come on the second question. We are doing exercise 2.4 and page number 46, question number 2. Question number 2, that show that x power a, x power b, then x plus b, multiply x b, x c, then b plus c, multiply x c, divided by x a, c plus a is equal to 1. Okay, here we will take the left hand side and then we will find the answer of left, final solution of the left hand side. So what will be the final solution of left hand side? Okay, now left hand side is equal to a x b, a plus b, multiply x b, x c, b plus c, multiply x c, x a, c plus a. This is the left hand side. Okay beta, as we there are the sum application that during multiplication, let a x a will multiply with x b. Here they are multiply. During multiplication, when base are same, the power is add. It will become a plus b. And now second application is division rule. This is, you can say that division rule, that when x a and x b are multiplied, so it can be write x a minus b when b's are same. So this is the division rule and this one is the multiplication. So according to division rule, it can be write x a minus b, then a plus b, multiply x b minus c b plus c, multiply x c minus a then c plus a. Understood beta? Okay, now x, it will multiply a minus b, a plus b, multiply x b minus c b plus c, multiply x c minus a c plus a. So base are same, power will add as we know that. First, as we already learned in the previous classes, that a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. When a plus b will multiply a minus b, we will obtain a square minus b square. We can prove a plus b product a minus b. So the first variable a will multiply both the next variable a minus b, so it will become a square minus ab, then plus sign, b will multiply with a and b both, ab and then plus minus minus b square, plus ab minus ab, a square minus b square will obtain. Understood beta? Okay. Now, according to formula, it can be write ax a square minus b square, multiply x b square minus c square, multiply x c square minus a square. So here base are same, power will add a plus b, a square minus b square, then plus b square minus c square, plus c square minus a square. So here the powers are same, base are same, so power will add x square, a square will cancel, minus b square plus b square minus c square plus c square. So x power just 0, and we know that any variable have a power 0, so it will give us just 1 answer. So x power 0, it means 1. So it's proved that left hand side is equal to right hand side, and this one is answer. Understood beta? Okay. Do the practice of this question in your notebook. Now, question number 3. Question number 3, simplify. So question number 3 come on the part number 2. Now page number 47. Part number 2. Part 2 is the square root of 216, 2 by 3, multiply 25, 1 by 2, then divide by 0.04, minus 1 by 2. Okay? No. 216. We can write 216 is equal to 6 multiply 6 multiply 6, and in index notation it can be write 6 power 3. So 216 is equal to 6 power 3. So write down 6 power 3 multiply with 2 power 2 by 3. Then multiply 25. We know that 25 is the square of 5. So 5 square multiply with 1 by 2. Power is multiplying here. So then 0.04, remove the point, write down 1, and after the point there are two digit 1 and 2, so we will write 20 in the denominator, it will become 4 by 100, new number. Then it can be cancelled with 3 with 3, 2 with 2, so 6 power 2 just left and 5 power 1 just. So here the power is negative, so convert into the positive power. So value will opposite, it can be write 100 by 4 divided power 1 by 2. अंडरस्टूड बेटा? ओके, नो, सिक्स पावर स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाई विथ फाइव देन डिवाइड बाय फोर वन्स आर फोर, फोर टूज आर एट, फोर फाइव आर ट्वेंटी फाइव, ट्वेंटी फाइव पावर वन बाय टू, देन सिक्स स्क्वायर मल्टीप्लाई विथ फाइव एंड ट्वेंटी फाइव इज द स्क्वायर ऑफ फाइव, इट कैन बी राइट फाइव पावर टू, टू कैन बी कैंसल विथ जस्ट टू, सिक्स स्क्वायर माइनस फाइव मल्टीप्लाई विथ फाइव एंड देन डिवाइड बाय फाइव, फाइव विथ कैंसल विथ जस्ट फाइव, सी सिक्स स्क्वायर अंडर रूट इज लेफ्ट. And as we know that beta square root, the value of square root is equal to 1 by 2. So put the value of square root here. It will become 6 square multiply 1 by 2 and square with cancel with the power 2. So just 6 is left. And this is your final answer. Understood beta? Okay. Now come on the last part, fourth part. And the fourth part is x power 3, then whole power 2 divided by x cube power 2, where x naught is equal to 0. So x cube, then power 2. X cube power 2 means x cube will multiply 2 times. Then divide x power 3 and then the power 3 of 2. So it means 3 will multiply 2 times. So here the base are same, power will add 3 plus 3 divide by x, 3 3s are 9. So x 3 plus 3, 6 divide by x, 9. So x 6 divided by x 9, it can be read just like this. So here the base are same, according to division rule it can be read 6 minus 9 and the answer will plus minus minus 9 minus 6 minus 3. So x minus 3, it mean x power 3. This is your answer. Understood beta? Okay, now do the practice of this other question in your notebook and rest question 1 and 3 is your task. Okay, now after this exercise, come on the new exercise. And the new one is the complex number. Okay, complex number. First, I will tell you about the complex number. Okay, beta. Complex number means the definition of complex number, a number of the form z is equal to a plus bi, where a and b are the real number and I is equal to minus 1 is called a complex number. So they are saying that z is equal to a plus bi, these type of the numbers are called a complex number, where a and b are real number and I is called the a and b is real number. Numbers and I is called the iota. What? Iota. I is called the iota. And the value of iota is under root minus 1. This is the specific value of iota. And what will be the iota square value? So take the square of both sides. Square with cancel with square root. So iota square is equal to minus 1. These are the two specific value of iota. Understood? And the combination of real number and imaginary number, the first part without iota, this part is called the real part. And the second number with iota, iota number is called a imaginary part. This part is called the imaginary part. And the first part is called the real part. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, a set of complex number is shown in the following diagram. So we can show a set of complex number. Fine? Okay. Complex number can be shown. First, complex number, and we also discussed that complex number is a set of real numbers and imaginary number. Real number and imaginary number. Real number means let a number is Z, a complex number is BI. So the real number A, the first part is real number and the second part is called the imaginary part. So the complex number is the combination of real number and imaginary number. Understood, beta? Okay, real number. We also discussed about the real number in the previous lecture. The real number is the combination of rational number and irrational number. Rational number and irrational number. Fine? A rational number means a number that can be terminated as, let's suppose, 3 by 4, as we already discussed. 3 by 4 give us an exact answer. So that's why we will say that 3 by 4 is called a rational number. And irrational number give us a not terminating answer. Just like the value of e, the value of under root 2, under root 5, and so on. So these type of the number are called a irrational number. Okay, and rational numbers mean a set of integers number. Yeah, rational number is a set of integers. And integers mean the number integers is a set of a whole number and negative natural number. Negative whole number and negative integer means negative natural numbers, whole numbers. This is the combination, integers is the combination for whole number and negative natural number. And whole number further can be classified into two other categories, means natural numbers and zero. So this is a set of a complex number. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, after this, come on the second point. Okay, the second point is the conjugate of a complex number. It's mean, today I will tell you about the conjugate of the complex number, that how we can find the conjugate of the complex number. Let a complex number is C is equal to A plus BI. This is the complex number as we know that. So how we can find the conjugate of the complex number? This, the conjugate of this number. So first conjugate, Z bar. This sign is called the bar. And this sign shows that we are finding the conjugate of a number, complex number. So it means the conjugate of a Z is equal to. Okay, now keep in mind, beta, that we will check just the sign of the iota value. Just sign of the iota value means the sign of the imaginary part. Okay, as we know that the first part is called the real part and this part is called the imaginary part. So look at the sign of the imaginary part. Here the sign of the imaginary part is plus. So it will be converted into the minus. So A minus BI. So it will become a conjugate of a complex number. Conjugate of a this number. Let a number is Z is equal to 3 plus 6I. This is the complex number. So what will be the conjugate of this number? Z bar is equal to, look at the sign of iota value. So here the plus, it will become minus. And the other value, let's suppose Z is equal to 4 minus 2i. So what will be the conjugate of this complex number? Z bar is equal to 4 minus will convert into the plus 2i. And this is the conjugate of this value.
अंडरस्टूड बेटा? ओके। एंड द थर्ड पॉइंट वी विल लर्न अबाउट द इक्वालिटी ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टी। इक्वालिटी ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर मीन्स इक्वालिटी, द साइन इक्वालिटी, द वर्ड इक्वालिटी शोस दैट मीन्स इक्वल। सो दे आर सेइंग दैट फॉर ऑल ए बी सी डी एंड द रियल नंबर्स एज ए प्लस बी आई विल इक्वल टू द सी प्लस डी आई इफ ए इज इक्वल टू सी एंड बी इज इक्वल टू डी। दिस इज द कैटेगरी। If A is equal to C, B is equal to D, then it must be A plus BI is equal to C plus DI. And this is the equality of the complex number, and you can say that this is the property of the complex number. Understood, beta? Okay. After the explanation, now come on the exercise questions. Now open your book. Turn out page number 49. And exercise 2.5. Exercise 2.5, page number 49. Okay, in the first question, evaluate means the find out the value of this iota. Okay, now come on the second part. Second part, iota power 50. So how we can find the final answer of this one? Iota power 50. Okay, beta, as we know that iota square is equal to minus 1 and iota is equal to under root minus 1. These are the specific value of iota square and iota. So keep in mind that we will make the first power square, because we know that iota square is equal to minus 1. So 2 will multiply which number? Then it will give us a 50. So 2 multiply with 25, it give us 50. So it's mean iota power 2 and then 25. So when we will open the bracket, 25 will multiply with 2, it will become again 50. So now put the value of iota square. As we know that iota square is equal to minus 1. Put the value of iota square and then write down power 25. Okay, now beta, keep in mind that when the power will odd, we will get minus 1 answer. And when the power will even, we will get plus 1 answer. How? But let's suppose a number minus 1 and the power is odd. Odd is just 3. So odd means minus 1 will multiply 3 times here. Minus 1, minus 1. So minus, minus, plus, plus, minus, minus. Again minus 1 you looked on. And when the power will even, let's suppose 6. So minus 1, 6 means minus 1 will multiply 6 times. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and minus 1. So minus 1, minus, plus, plus, minus, 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 plus, plus, minus, 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 plus. So the final answer will just plus 1. Understood, beta? Okay, this is your answer. Now rest all the questions are your homework. So do all the questions in your notebook. Understood, beta? Okay, now come on the second question. Second question is, write the conjugate of the following numbers. They are saying they find the conjugate of this number. So as we already learned that how we can find the conjugate of a number. So question number 2 and part 2. 3 minus 5, 5. So let the z is equal to this one, 3 minus 5, 5. So what will be the conjugate of these numbers? Conjugate will represent by z bar. Then we will check that the sign of imaginary part. The first part is called the real. It means 3 is the real part and minus 5, 5 is the imaginary part. So 5, 5, the sign of the 5i imaginary part is minus, so it will convert into the plus sign. So 3 plus 5i, and this is called the conjugate of this number, and this is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay, now come on the fifth part. Fifth part is minus 4 minus I. So let z is equal to minus 4 minus I. So then z bar will become what? So just we will focus on the sign of imaginary part, just not real part. So the real part will write same, will remain same. Now the plus minus 1 will become plus 1, plus iota. So this is your final answer, and this is the conjugate of this number. Understood, beta? Okay, rest all the questions are your homework. Now come on the question number 3. Question number 3. The question number 3 is, write the real imaginary part of the following number. So these are the complex number. They are saying that write on the real and imaginary part separate. Now the come on the part 3. Minus 3i plus 2. So beta, look at this complex number. So which one is the real part? First write on real part. Which one is the real part without iota? So 2 is without iota, it means this is the real part. And no, sorry, imaginary part. Okay, iota value is called the imaginary part. So it means minus 3i is the imaginary part. Understood, beta? Okay. Now, come on the fifth part. The fifth part is just minus 3 iota. So what will be the real part? 0. No any number here. So it means 0 is the real part. And what will be the imaginary part? Minus 3i. Iota value with sign. This is called the imaginary part. Understood, beta? Okay, now rest all the questions are your homework. These are the so easy questions. Now come on the question number 4. And question number 4 is the last question of this exercise. Find the value of x and y if x plus iota y plus 1 is equal to 4 minus 3i. So what will be the value of x and y? Question number 4. X plus iota y plus 1 is equal to 4 minus 3 iota. Find out x and y. So first we will arrange the real part and the imaginary part. So x, and this is also real part. So write down the real part first and then write down the imaginary part. 4 minus 3i. So the real part will equal to the real part, and imaginary part will equal to the imaginary part. Equal sign means they are same. So x plus, according to the equality of the complex number, x plus 1 is equal to 4. When a plus bi is equal to this one, it's mean x, the real part will equal to the real part, imaginary part will equal to the imaginary part. So y is equal to minus 3. So y is equal to minus 3, and this is equation number 1. So we can find the value of x from equation number 1. To find out the value of x, equation number 1, we will solve equation number 1. And equation number 1 is x plus 1 is equal to 4. So what will be the value of x? Leave the variable on the left side, and constant number will come on the, will jump on the right side. So plus 1 will become minus 1, x, 4 minus 1, 3. So the value of x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus 3. This is your final answer. Understood, beta?
Okay.
Now come on the new exercise. And for the new exercise, first we will discuss some points. Okay, and new exercise consists of some points. In this exercise, I will tell you about the basic operation on complex numbers. In this exercise, we will learn that how we can apply basic operations of complex number on complex number. Fine. The basic operation means multiplication, addition, subtraction, and division. So these are the basic operation. These four operations are called the basic operation, and how we can apply these four operations on the complex number. So we will discuss one by one. Okay. Now let's suppose addition means that let's suppose there are two complex number. The first one is a plus bi and the second one is a minus bi. So there are two complex numbers. So how we can add? So a plus b, first we will write the first complex number, then put the plus sign because we are doing addition. So plus sign and then write on the second complex number. Now add these two numbers. A, open the bracket, a plus bi plus a minus bi. So plus bi can be cancelled with minus bi, just a plus a, it will become 2a. Yes? Okay. And second operation is multiplication. That how we can multiply two numbers. Fine? Okay, there are two numbers. Z1 is a plus bi. And Z2 is equal to C plus DI. There are two complex numbers. So how we can multiply these two complex numbers? So Z1 into Z2, it means they are multiplied. Then write on A plus BI into C plus DI. Okay, now the E will multiply first C plus DI, both these numbers. So A multiply with C, AC. A multiply with DI, it will become ADI. Then second number, okay, plus BI will multiply with C and then plus BI will multiply with DI. BI multiply with C, it will become plus BCI. You can write just like this. Then put the plus sign. Then BI multiply DI, BDI square, I multiply I square. And we know that I square is equal to minus 1. So AC plus ADI plus BCI plus BD, put the value of I square, minus 1. So AC plus ADI plus BCI and then plus minus minus BD, Z1 and Z2. So this is your final answer if we can't further simplify this one. Okay, and the third operation is subtraction, that how we can subtract two numbers. So let there are two complex number, A is A plus BI, and the second complex number is A minus BI. So how we can subtract? Z1 minus Z2 is equal to, first write on the first complex number, then put the negative sign, and then write on the second one. Now open the bracket, minus A. Minus minus, when we will open the bracket, the sign will change. Minus minus, it will become plus bi. So minus a plus a, it will be cancelled. Just bi plus bi, it will become 2bi. This is your final answer. It's mean we can subtract. And no, the fourth one is division. That how we can divide two complex number. So let there are two complex numbers. Z1 is A plus BI. And Z2 is equal to C plus DI. So how we can divide it? Z1 divided by Z2 is equal to A plus BI divided by C plus DI. So beta, keep in mind that in division, how we can simplify this question? So beta, we will multiply the denominator. What? Multiply the numerator and denominator by C plus DI, because the conjugate of C plus DI is the conjugate of first. It means first we will find the conjugate of C plus DI in the denominator value, means the denominator value, find out their conjugate. So C plus DI, the conjugate value of this complex number is C minus DI. So then we will multiply C minus DI with numerator and denominator both. And then it will multiply the A plus BI, C minus DI, and then A plus B, A minus B. According to formula, it will become A square minus B square. Then they will multiply A plus BI according to multiplication rule. The first number will multiply with both this number. C square minus D square, I square. And I square is equal to minus 1. Put the value of I square. C square. Then when we will put the value of I square minus 1, so minus 1 it will become plus D square. And after the multiplication, we will simplify this question. Fine? Okay. No. This was your explanation. Now come on the example number 1. Example 2 is, the number is 1 divided by 1 plus 2i. So they are saying that express in the standard form. Standard form. And the standard form is A plus BI. Means we will convert into the A plus BI form. So how we can convert? As we know that 1 plus 2i. When any complex number is dividing or in division form, so how we can convert, how we can solve this question? As we already discussed the division rule of the complex number. So first we will find the conjugate of this number. What will be the conjugate of this number? 1 minus 2i. So then we will multiply 1 minus 2i in the numerator and denominator both. So when we will multiply with 1, it will become 1 minus 2i. And then write a 1 plus 2i, 1 minus 2i. 1 minus 2i divided by A plus B, A minus B. According to formula, A square minus B square is equal to A plus BI, A plus B, sorry, A minus B. Fine? So A square means the first number is A, 1 whole square minus the second value is B square. So 1 minus 2i divided by 1 square, 1 minus 2 square into I square. 1 minus 2i, 1 minus 2 2s are 4, I square. And we know that the value of I square, 4, I square is equal to minus 1. So put the value of I square here, minus 1. So 1 minus 2i divided by 1 minus minus plus 4. So 1 minus 2i divided by 5. So it can be write 1 by 5, as they are saying that standard form a plus bi means a minus, so 2 by 5 i, and this form is called the standard form. This is your answer. Understood, beta? Okay. And example number 3 is same as the express. This one is standard a plus bi, same as like just example number 2. Now come on the example number 4. Example number 4, there solve 3 minus 4i into x plus 5i is equal to 1 plus 0i for real number x and y, where a iota is minus 1 under root. So it means they are saying that find out the value of x and y. Example number 4. Example number 4. And the question is 3 minus 4i. And the next one is x plus yi is equal to 1 plus 0i. So how we can find the x and y value? First we will multiply 3 with x, 3x plus 3yi minus 4xi minus plus minus 4yi square is equal to 1 plus 0i. So 3x minus, take the I common here, so it will become 3y minus 4x minus 4y, put the value of iota. As we know that iota square is equal to minus 1. So minus 1, 1 plus 0i. So 3x minus iota, 3y minus 4x minus minus plus 4y, 1 plus 0i. So 3x plus 4y, real part and imaginary part. Separate the imaginary part. So 3x plus 4y, and it can be read beta just like this. One more. Plus, take the common, so it will become just write down 4x minus 3y. It can be right just like this one. It's your choice, beta. Okay, now the real part will equal to the real part and imaginary part will equal to the imaginary part. Make the equations as we already done. Equation number 1, 4x minus 3y is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Fine? Okay. Now find out the value of x and y according to equation 1 and 2. So first, equation number, how we can solve these equations, both these equations. 3y and 4x, and the second one is, now simplify this question, it's your task. Fine? That how we can find the x and y value as we already done in the previous example. Okay. Now after the examples, come on the exercise 2.6. Page number 52. Exercise 2.6. And question number 1. Look at the question number 1. Identify the following statement as true or false. Which one is the true and which one is the false? Okay, the first one is question 1. Okay, they are saying that minus under root 3, under root minus 3 is equal to 3. Yes or no? True or false? This is the statement is true or false. So beta, minus 3 under root 2, it can be right under root 2 minus 3 square. 2 time means 2 time, they are multiplied 2 time. So, oh no, as we know that the value of under root is 1 by 2. So apply the value of under root, minus 3, 1 by 2, multiply 2, 2 with cancel with 2. So minus 3 is equal to 3? No. This is wrong statement. False. Understood? Okay. No. The second part, question number 1, and the second statement is iota power 73 is equal to minus iota. So as we know that iota square, first we will write square and then which number will multiply with square, it will become 73. No any number, it's mean square. 2 will multiply with 26 multiplied 2, 50 to no. 36, when we will multiply 36 with 2, it will give us 72. So iota 72, here is iota 73, just one iota is left, so write down iota 1, fine, and then minus iota. When we will multiply, it will become 72 and base are same, so it the base of here 1, so it will become again 73. So iota square means minus 1 power 36 into iota is equal to minus iota power e1. 36 is e1, it's mean it gives us a positive answer. So minus iota, so plus iota is equal to minus iota. No, this is wrong statement. No, find out the third one, it's your task. You can check that this is the true statement, iota power 10 is equal to minus 1 and now. And the fourth one is the complex conjugate of this number is this one. So you can check that complex conjugate means the conjugate number of this, the conjugate of this number. What will be the conjugate of this number? Fine? Okay. Now the difference. Difference means the subtraction of the this number, z and its conjugate. Fifth part is z is given that a plus bi and the conjugate of this number is a minus bi. So then find out z minus z bar. What will be the z minus z bar? They give us a real number means without imaginary part. So it's your task. The sixth part, six is if a minus b and minus b plus 3 iota is equal to 5 plus 8i, then what will be the value of a and b? So imaginary part will equal to the imaginary part, real part will equal to the real part, and then find out the value of x and y. It's your task. Now, seventh, product. Product means multiplication of complex number and its conjugate is always a non-negative real numbers means let there are two numbers. The first one is complex number is a plus bi. This is we are doing question number 1 and part 7. What will be the conjugate of this number a minus bi? And they are saying that the product of means z bar. What will be the product of this number? Is a real number or not? So a plus bi, a minus bi. multiply these two number, a with a square, a bi, a will multiply with bi, it will become abi, then a bi plus abi plus minus minus bi square, b square I square. So a square, it can be cancelled, a square minus b square iota square is equal to minus 1. So a square minus minus plus b square. So it's proof that the multiplication of a complex number and its conjugate number is always give us a real number. Okay, now do the practice of this, all the questions in your notebook. Now come on the second question. Now the second question is, express each complex number in the standard form. Means standard form, that how we can, means there are some operations, so how we can add, how we can separate, as we already done examples. So now it's your task that first, okay, I will do just only one part. Question number 2 and second part. The second part is 2, 5 plus 4i minus 3, 7 plus 4i. So how we can add and separate? First we will multiply, 2 5s are 10, after the bracket this number, quotient numbers, when we will open the brackets, this quotient number will multiply each number inside the bracket. 10 plus 2 4s are 8i minus 3 7s are 21 minus plus minus 3 4s are 12i. So then 10 minus 21 then plus 8i minus 12i. So 10 minus 21 minus 11 plus minus 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 12 minus 8 4i. This is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now come on the question number 3. Question number 3 is, simplify and write your answer in the form of a plus bi. Simplify and then we will write the answer a plus b. Simple, we will multiply and then we will write the answer a plus bi. Okay, the fourth part is, means the fourth part. Two minus 3i and 3 minus 2i. So 2 minus 3i, then the conjugate, this sign is show us means bar, conjugate. So first we will find the conjugate, 3 plus 2i, and then we will multiply and then simplify it. Fine? Now it's your task. These are the two easy questions. Okay, now come on the question number 4. Question number 4 is, question number 4, simplify and write your answer in the form of a plus bi. Fine? Okay, then how we can simplify? Now come on the question number 5, question 4, I plus 1 plus I whole square divided by 1 minus iota whole square. So first 1 plus iota whole square apply on both numerator and denominator. So 1 plus i square means we will write 2 times, 1 minus iota, 1 minus iota. Now multiply these two numbers, 1 plus iota plus iota plus iota square, and multiply it, 1 minus iota minus iota, 1 माइनस ओएटा माइनस ओएटा माइनस माइनस प्लस आयोटा स्क्वायर. सो वन आयोटा आयोटा प्लस टू आयोटा एंड देन आयोटा स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन. पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आयोटा स्क्वायर माइनस वन वन एंड माइनस टू आयोटा एंड देन पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ आयोटा स्क्वायर माइनस वन. वन प्लस टू आयोटा माइनस आयोटा एंड देन वन माइनस टू आयोटा माइनस वन. प्लस वन कैन बी कैंसल विथ माइनस वन. प्लस वन माइनस वन सो प्लस टू आयोटा डिवाइड माइनस टू आयोटा. फाइन ओके नो टू आयोटा डिवाइड बाय माइनस टू आयोटा. सो द कंजुगेट ऑफ दिस नंबर व्हाट विल बी द कंजुगेट ऑफ दिस नंबर. प्लस टू आई इट्स मीन प्लस टू आई विल मल्टीप्लाई बोथ न्यूमिनेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर. अंडरस्टूड. Now simplify this question and find out the answer. It's your task now. Now come on the question number 5. Question number 5, they are saying they calculate E, the first part Z is Z conjugate and then Z plus Z conjugate and then the second, third and D part. Fine. Okay, and there are the complex number and they are saying that apply these functions on the complex number. So I will do just only one part. And part number 4. And the part number 4 is 4 minus 3 iota divided by 2 plus 4 iota. So they are saying that in first A part, find out Z conjugate. So that Z is equal to 4 minus 3i, 4i. Then what will become Z conjugate? As we know that 4 minus 3i divided by 2 minus 2 plus 4i, that how we can find the conjugate of this number. First we will find the conjugate of denominator and then that conjugate will multiply with numerator and both denominator. So the conjugate of this number 2 minus 4i then 2 minus 4i. Multiply 4 2s are 8 minus 4 4s are 16i minus 3 2s are 6i minus minus plus 3 4s are 12i square divide by a plus b a minus b. Then 8 minus 16i minus 6i plus 12 iota square minus 1. A plus B, A minus B according to a formula. A square minus B square. 8 minus 16 minus 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 plus. So 16 and 6, 22. I plus minus minus 12. Divide by 2, 2 is 4 minus 4, 4 is 16. I square. 8 plus minus minus 12 minus 8 minus 4 minus 22i divide by 4 minus 16 minus 1. So minus 4 minus 22i divide by 4 minus minus plus 16. So minus 4 minus 22i divide by 20. Fine. Okay, now it will become minus 4 divided by 20 minus 22 divided by 20. 4 1s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 2 2 1, 2 10s are. So the new number, the answer is 4 by 5, sorry 1 by 5 minus 11 by 10. And this is your answer. Fine? Okay. Now, The next part is now come on to question number 5, and question number 5 I will do just only one part. Fourth part, C is equal to 4 minus 3i divided by 2 plus 4i. So in first part, A part, they are saying that find out the conjugate of C. So how we can find the conjugate of C? C conjugate will become 4 plus 3i and then 2 minus 4i. Now simplify, how we can simplify and find out the answer in standard notation. Then 2 minus 4i, what will be the conjugate of this number 2 plus 4i? It will multiply both the numerator and denominator. So then multiply numerator with 4, multiply with 2 and 4. 4 2s are 8, 4 4s are 16i, plus 3 2s are 6i, plus 3 4s are 12i. Fine, okay, and then 2 minus 4i, 2 plus 4i.
That's not better.
Okay, sorry, I square. Then 8 plus 16i plus 6i plus 12i square minus 1. 2 minus 4i, 2 plus 4i. And 8 plus 16 plus 6, 22i plus minus 12 divided by a plus b, a minus b. We know that a plus b, a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So write down 2 a square minus b square. A plus minus. So 12 minus 8 minus 4. Plus 22i divided by 2 2s are 4 minus 4 4s are 16 I square is equal to minus 1. Minus 4 plus 22i divided by 4 minus plus 16. So minus 4 plus 22i divided by 20. So it can be right. Minus 4 divided by 20 plus 22 divided by 20i. 4 1s are 4, 4 5s are 20, 2 11s are 22, 2 10s are. So the final answer is 1 by 5 plus minus 1 by 5 plus 11 by 10 iota. This is your final answer. Understood, beta? Okay. This is part A. Now part. In part B, what they are saying? Part B. They are saying the addition of Z and conjugate of Z. So it is D. And we are doing part 4. Question 5. Okay, first we will write, as they are saying that find out Z plus Z conjugate. It means first we will write Z 4 minus 3i divided by 2 plus 4i. This is Z. And then plus sign, write on Z conjugate, and we know that Z conjugate is 4 plus 3i divided by 2 minus 4i, the opposite of this number. Now how we can add these two numbers? But find out the LCM of these two numbers. So we will write both these two numbers. Then 2 plus 4i divided by this number. So what will be the answer? 2 minus 4 I just left. 2 plus 4 I will cancel 2 plus 4 I and then just 2 minus 4 I will left. And 2 minus 4 I will multiply with the numerator. 4 minus 3 I. Then plus 2 minus 4 I will cancel with 2 minus 4 I just 2 plus 4 I will left. Then it will multiply with numerator. Now multiply these two numbers, 2 4s are 8, minus 2 3s are 6i, minus 4 4s are 16i, minus plus minus 4 3s are 12i square. Plus 2 4s are 8, plus 2 3s are 6i, plus 4 4s are 16i, plus 4 3s are 12i square. Divide by a plus b, a minus b according to formula, a square minus b square. Now 8 minus minus plus, so minus 22 I plus 12 I square minus 1 plus 8 plus 22 I plus 12 I square minus 1. 2 2s are 4, minus 4 4s are 16, I square. 8 minus 22 I, minus 12, plus minus minus 12, plus 8, plus 22 I, minus 12. Divide by 4 minus 1, I square minus 1, minus minus plus 16. Now, will become 8 plus 8, 16, then 22i with cancel plus 2i, minus 12, minus 12, minus 24, divided by 20, 16, then 16 plus 16 minus, minus 24, minus 16, 8 with minus sign. 4 2s are 8, 4 5s are 20. So minus 2 by 5. This is your final answer of part 2. Okay, now C part. Okay, now question 5, C part. After the C, come on the D part. C is the difference of two numbers, complex and real, and complex number, conjugate and the complex number. Fine. Okay, now come on the D part. Part D is, they are saying that find out the product of Z into Z bar, means the complex number and the conjugate number. Okay, we are doing the fourth one. And fourth part, question 1, fourth part, and 4 is 4 minus 3i divided by 2 plus 4i, and the conjugate of this number is 4 plus 3i divided by 2 minus 4i. So multiply these two numbers, 4 multiply with 4 minus 3i. 4 plus 3i, then 2 plus 4i, 2 minus 4i. So a minus b, a plus b according to formula, it will become a square minus b square. Then here a square minus b square. Fine. Okay. Now, next, a square minus b according to formula beta, okay? Now, the next one is 4 to 4, 16 minus 3, 3 is a 9, I square. Okay, 2, 2 is a 4 minus 4, 4 is a 16, I square. 16 minus 9 minus 1 divided by 4 minus 16 minus 1. So 16 minus minus plus 9 and then 4 plus 20. 9, 10, 25 and then it will become, 20. 5 5s are 25, 4, 5 4s are 20. So it will become 5 divided by 4. This is your final answer after multiplication. Understood, beta? Okay, now come on the question number 6. In question number 6, if z is equal to this one and w is equal to this one, then show that. Show means prove that. The first part. Part first, they are saying that z plus w and then conjugate is equal to z conjugate plus w conjugate. If z is equal to, the given value of z is equal to 2 plus 3i and w is equal to 5 minus 4i. So first we will solve left hand side. Left hand side is equal to z plus w bar. It means first we will add z plus w. Write down the value of z and then w, and then we will take the conjugate. Put the plus sign here because they are adding. So 2, open the bracket, 2 plus 5, 7, plus, minus, minus, 4i minus 3i, minus i, then conjugate. So after the conjugate, it will become 7 plus i. This is left hand side. Now solve the right hand side. And right hand side is z bar plus w bar. It means, as we know that z is equal to 2 plus 3i. So what will become z bar? 2 minus 3i. And the given value of w is equal to 5 minus 4i. Then 5 w bar will become 5 plus 4i. Now add these two conjugate numbers. 2 minus 3i plus 5 plus 4i. So 2 plus 5 minus 3i plus 4i. 2 plus 7 plus minus minus 4i minus 3i plus i. And this is z plus w bar. Right hand side. So prove it. This is your answer. Understood, beta? Okay. Now rest all the parts are your homework. Do the practice of these other parts in your notebook. Now come on the last question of this exercise. Okay, beta, now come on the last question. Question number 7 of exercise 2.6. And I will do just only one part. They are saying they'll find out the value of x and y. So how we can find the value of x and y? First we will multiply these two numbers. So it will become 2x plus 2yi minus 3xi minus 3yi is equal to 4 plus i. So 2x plus 2yi minus 3xi minus, i square. So it will be 3y and I square minus 1. So 2x, and take the common I from here. And minus minus plus 3y. So arrange the real number and then plus 2y minus 3x I is equal to 4 plus I. Now make the equation's real part will equal to the real one. 4. This is equation number 1. 2y minus 3x, this is the equation number 1. The coefficient of iota is equal to 1, it means this is equation number 2. Now, according to this linear equation, these two linear equations, and we know that how we can solve two linear equations by finding the x and y values. So, look at the coefficient of x. Here the coefficient of x is 2 and here is 3. If we will multiply with 3 here, so it will become 3 to the 6, and if we will multiply 2 with equation number 2, so it will become 6, and variable same, then we will add or subtract. Fine? Okay. Now, when we will multiply here with 3, so keep in mind that when we will multiply with any number, so that number will also multiply in the right side. Okay, both. Okay, 3 2s are 6x, 3 3s are 9y, 3 4s are 12. This is equation number 3. Now, for equation number 2, we will multiply with 2 both sides, 2 2s are 4. So, first write on the x variable. 2 3s are 6 minus 6x because 3x have a negative sign. Then plus 2 2s are 4y and 2 1s are 2. This is equation number 4. Now from equation number 3 and 4 we can find the value of y. So add 3 and 4, equation number 4. 6x plus 9y is equal to 12. Then minus 6x plus 4y is equal to 2. So it can be cancelled, plus minus can be cancelled. So plus 9 plus 4, 13y, 12 plus 2, 14. So leave the y here, 13 will divide on the other side. So this is the value of y. So we have to find the value of y. Now we can find the value of x by putting the value of y in an equation. It's your choice. You can put the value of y in equation 1, 2, 3 or 4 in any equation. Fine? Okay, now as we know that equation 1 is this one and equation number 2 is this one. Fine? Okay, now put the value of y in 4. So minus 6x plus 4, 14 divided by 3, 13, here y is equal to 2. Now minus 6x, multiply it, 4, 4s are 16, 4, 1 and 6, 5, 13, 2. Now move on the right side, so it will become minus 56 divided by 13. Now the number is minus 6x is equal to 2 minus 56 divided by 13. So we can write a whole number into the fraction form. Now how we can convert the small fraction to the long fraction by LCM method, as we know that. The LCM of 13 and 1 is 13. So 1 divided by 13, 13 multiply with 2, 26. Minus 13 divided by 13, 1, 1 multiply 56, 56. So 26 minus 56, what will be the answer? 0, 5 to the 30, minus 30, divided by 30, minus 6x. So leave the x just here. The coefficient move on the other side. Here the coefficient is multiplied with the variable. So So other side it will multiply, divide, sorry. So minus sign will cancel with the minus sign. 6 ones are 6, 6 5s are 30. So 5 by 30. This is the value of x. Understood, beta? Okay, do the practice of this, all the question in your notebook.